CNN host Erin Burnett engaged in what I'm going to call a minor form of torture during an interview with George Santos this week, because Erin Burnett forced George Santos to sit there and watch a supercut of different clips of him lying about various different parts of his past. And she made him sit there and watch the whole thing. Here is how it went down. Take a look.
My grandparents survived the Holocaust.
My mom was a 9/11 survivor.
They sent me to a good prep school, so, and which was Harrisman Prep in the Bronx.
I actually went to school on a volleyball scholarship. When I was in Baruch, we were the number one volleyball
team. Did you graduate?
But I put myself through college and got an MBA from NYU.
So, Congressman, I just want to give you a chance. You've admitted, I understand, you didn't graduate from NYU. Horace Mann says they've searched the records. There's no evidence that George Santos or any alias attended Horace Mann. Can you explain to anybody watching that why you said some of the things that you've said, which you yourself have admitted are not true?
Erin, you know what would be great? And I'm not deflecting, but I'm just going to call you out here in CNN. Have you brought Joe Biden on the network and spoken about all the things he said across the last 46 years? Because I haven't seen it. Joe Biden was top of his graduating class.
Congressman Santos, this interview is between you and me, and it is about
you. I understand, but I understand.
Now, the reason I describe that is a mild form of torture. And for a normal person, it would be, right? George Santos has no shame, so I'm sure he wasn't tortured by any of that. But could you imagine if you were forced to sit there and somebody played like 8 video clips of some of the cringiest, like worst things you've ever said? You would be just absolutely catatonic. Like, that would be the worst thing ever. And there's George Santos having to sit through it. And then, of course, at the end, obviously, immediately, I'm not going to deflect. And then he totally deflects, like, not to deflect or anything, but what about Biden? He later on tried to argue with Burnett that, hey, you brought me on to talk about the impeachment. And she countered by saying, like, we told you we were going to talk about a lot of issues. So that's kind of what we're doing here. Here's the big question, though. Why would you even bring George Santos on TV? I mean, is it because you wanted to do that, like, fun little moment there? And it was fun. And he deserved it. And I'm not saying you shouldn't have done it. You absolutely should. But at the same time, the guy brings no substance to any conversation anywhere. So there's no point in bringing him on, unless your goal is to make him look like a fool, in which case I'm 100% going to support you doing that. So the other question is George Santos. Why would you even agree to go give an interview to CNN? Like, are you really that desperate for attention? You just want to be in the spotlight so badly that you don't even mind if you get totally humiliated during interviews as long as you get your face on that camera? Because that's what it seems like to me. George Santos seems like the kind of guy, much like Donald Trump, he doesn't care whose camera it is. He doesn't care what network it is, what podcast it is. You invite him on the air and by God, he's going to show up because he's desperate for that attention. Marjorie Taylor Greene and Matt Gaetz also fall into that category. But just a lesson for the media. One, that's how you do it. What CNN did right there was in fact brilliant. Credit where credit is due. High props to CNN for that. Media number two, if you're not going to do what CNN just did, don't invite George Santos on your programs. Again, he has nothing to offer, no expertise on anything, except maybe lying. Other than that, let him fade into obscurity as he awaits his criminal trial. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.